the sandy beach of the mighty river Brahmaputra in Guwahati and the skies above rejoiced, even as many kites, some designed like eagles and other birds, some like octopus, and all with a splash of color, soared high to celebrate the people's wish to fly like birds in complete freedom. This was the sixth edition of the annual Jeevan Kite and River Festival, which is a tribute to the river Brahmaputra, as well as an answer to the unspoken desire of many to relive their childhood days of gay abandon, which many urban youth of today miss out due to study pressure and modern gizmos. The fun-filled event refreshingly witnessed many young girls flying kites, which made every onlooker realize that in the Northeast, girls are not restricted. Another message left by the event is that to soar high like kites, one has to rise against the wind, again like kites, which cannot rise if it goes with the wind. So struggles are intrinsic in life. As the sun set, sky lanterns were released in the air and the entire beach looked festive.
We are a voluntary organization actually. We are about 300 volunteers. So for the last 6 years we are organizing this carnival. This is Brahmaputra campaign carnival. This is also known as Jeevan Kite and River Festival. So this is just not a single kite festival. Basically this is a tribute to the river, because Brahmaputra river is a mighty river. It is the fifth largest river in terms of flowing rate and the largest in India. So actually we want to create an awareness of an urban kind, because the urban youth will come to the riverside and they will enjoy the nature. They will feel a sense of belonging to the river, and that's how they will generate some awareness about the river.
Enjoy kar rahe hain aur matlab vacation mein acha lagta hai. Ye festival jab hota hai to acha lagta hai friends ke sath enjoy karne mein. तो सब लोग आके एंजॉय करते हैं पूरा।
The Kachai Farming and Processing Cooperative Society, supported by the Manipur Organic Mission Agency or MOMA, a unit of the state's Horticulture Department, recently organized a lemon festival at the Kachai Playground in the Tangkhul Naga inhabited Ukhrul district. Over 250 lemon farmers wearing their traditional attires participated in the festival and sold over 4 metric tons of lemons. This lemon festival started in 2005 and has now become an annual event. Among others, local farmer Pamrai Kasung has set up his own Zingthawar lemon organic farm and planted 3,500 lemon plants. Once he gets fruits from all the plants, he is expecting about rupees 20 lakh per year from his organic lemon farm. But he cautioned that this plant needs proper maintenance to prevent devastation by insects.
The farm is 2,000 yen. About 3,500 plants. 100 to 150 plants production. 1,000 kg 금버디 우직시 방에 아주 시 고인의 표준에 영비럽디 5 years 만동드디 at least 20 lakhs 금버디 lakhs 내이시.
This lemon is one of the 10 horticultural products from the northeast India, which has got the geographical index tag because of its juice, ascorbic acid content, taste and aroma. The State Horticulture Department has been providing technical support to get full certification for this product.
Kachai lemon has been given GI tag in 2016 March, and this time we are planning to go organic, and MOMA, Manipur Organic Mission Agency, is giving technical support in order to get full certification.
We will go in for a short break here. Stay tuned to this channel. We'll be right back.
First Word, a complete monthly magazine of the Northeast, packaging news and current affairs, sports, culture, festivals, achievers, life in metro, and lots more. Buy the magazine today from stalls across the Northeast and New Delhi, or subscribe for 12 issues by paying Rs. 320 online. For details, contact 98101-29327.
Music, dance, drama, and other cultural activities are the essence of life in the Northeast. In the absence of glitzy malls with cineplexes, culture entertains the people. Watch on!
In a great show of integration, Delhi-based Manipuri cultural troupe headed by artist Shyam Singh performed Mizoram's popular bamboo dance in a recently held dance festival in the national capital. Members of this troupe are all Manipuri youth based in Delhi who generally perform Manipuri folk, classical, martial arts, besides various tribal dances.
Our group is presenting such Manipuri folk and martial arts and some classical and folk dances and other parts of tribal dances. And today we are doing some Mizoram dance.
On this occasion, however, they decided to embrace Mizo culture. Bamboo dance is actually known as Cherao dance in Mizoram. Young Mizo boys and girls in traditional attire perform this dance with long bamboo sticks. In this dance, men usually sit facing one another and tap long bamboo poles to rhythmic beats. Girls wearing their best traditional costumes dance out and in between the bamboo poles. The Manipuri team beautifully performed this Mizo dance, upholding the fact that embracing each other's culture will go a long way to promote oneness, bonding, knowledge about each other, and in effect, integration. Another group led by Delhi-based artist Himanshu Saini performed Bihu dance in the festival. Three males and three female members performed Bihu dance to the tune of Bihu songs. This dance is performed during spring festival in Assam, known as Rongali or Bhogali Bihu. This joyous dance is characterized by brisk dance steps, rapid hand movements and a rhythmic swaying of the hips, basically to represent youthful passion. Here too, the youth upheld friendship and bonding.
I'm not a music person, but जो last में इनका बांस के ऊपर कुछ tribal के ऊपर था, excellent. All over is very soothing and very meditative program. और ऐसे ही ministry को करते रहना चाहिए, culture and ministry को, जिससे कि public में awareness है.
Well friends, we have to wrap up the episode here. We will recharge the mobiles of three lucky contest winners. They are...
For our contest section, we had asked, what did we show in the last segment? The answer is... Fashion show, Northeast Fashion Weekend in Guwahati. The winners are... Aram Ranjit Meite from Imphal, Manipur, Roshanara Sheikh from Guwahati, Assam, and Sozin Rabha from Gualpara, Assam.
Congratulations, winners! Check out your mobiles in a week's time for the recharge. For others who want to participate, the easy question is, what did we show in our entertainment section today? SMS your answers to 99540-24434 or mail it to youth_folio@yahoo.com. We will recharge the mobiles of three lucky contest winners with Rs. 1000 each. See you all next Thursday at the same time and on the same channel. Until then, goodbye and take care.